everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. Water's in you and me.
Hi there, welcome to Water Education TV. We're back with another hands-on activity that you can use in your classroom. Let's start today's activity with a question. When I water this plant, where does the water go? We might say it soaks in, but what does that really mean? The water is actually moving down through the interconnected spaces between soil particles, called pore spaces. When there's no room for air left in the pore spaces, we say that the area is saturated, and also that I've overwatered my plant. My gardening skills aside, when water has filled all the pore spaces, leaving no room for air and creating a saturated zone, we call it groundwater.
About 25% of all the water used daily in the U.S. for drinking, washing, manufacturing, and just about everything comes from groundwater. The upper boundary of the saturated zone is called the water table, and any unsaturated zones above that are not considered groundwater. If this all sounds a little confusing, you can brush up on your groundwater knowledge with the Discover Groundwater in Springs Kids Activity Booklet. You can find it at store.projectwet.org, and you'll need it for this activity. Today we're building our own mini groundwater flow model inside a 2-liter pop bottle. We'll start by cutting off the top so we can just use the bottom of the bottle. Next, we need to layer our different types of soil inside the bottle. I'll make an impermeable layer of clay at the bottom, then I'll layer some gravel, coarse sand, and fine sand on top. Now let's make it rain. As precipitation falls on the surface, we see the water flowing down gradient until it reaches an impermeable layer underground. As soil becomes saturated, we see the groundwater taking shape. When humans need to use groundwater, they often drill a well down past the water table in order to pump that water out. We'll model that using a pump dispenser from a lotion bottle. Now the water is drawn along the saturated zone towards the pump. What happens eventually if we keep pumping without adding precipitation to the surface? How does this relate to the real world of groundwater? Experiment with your model using different types of soil, different amounts of water pumped out, and different amounts of precipitation. What did you find? Thanks for joining us on Water Education TV. I hope you'll try this activity in your classroom, along with the other fun games and experiments, in the Discover Groundwater in Springs Kids Activity Booklet. Let us know in the comments what other water-related topics you'd like us to cover in future episodes. See you next time.
Water is everywhere, everywhere, everywhere.